We have this live presentation with a video. How can we adjust the volume and speed of this video right on the screen using a slider like this? Watch till the end to learn how to control your video's live presentation easily by using a slider in ActivePresenter with these stages. Prepare before adding sliders. Create a volume slider. Create a speed slider. Preview and export. Firstly, make sure you have inserted all materials into the slide. To help watchers recognize the area where they can control the volume and speed of the video, you can add suitable shapes and icons in the Insert tab. Now, you are ready to add the sliders. Choose Slider in the Insert tab. Then drag the mouse on the canvas to insert the slider. In the Format tab, choose one among these slider styles. Then, customize its track, thumb, and border here. Now, go to the Size and Properties tab, Slider section, Variable, choose AP Volume. You will see these default settings. Min represents the minimum volume of your video is 0 or mute, while max shows the maximum volume is 100%. Step defines the size of each movement on the track, which is 1. Now, choose the status whether you want the volume changing takes place while dragging or after dragging the slider. Finally, to show the volume percentage while dragging the thumb, add a text box next to the slider. Then, go to Home tab, Reference, System, choose AP Volume. While variables store data, variable references retrieve and display the data anywhere in your course. The result will be like this. To make the process the most minimal, copy and paste the volume slider and its text box to create the speed slider. Change the slider's variable to AP speed and customize the options as you want. With these settings, this means the minimum speed of the video is 50% and the maximum is 200%. And each time dragging the thumb, the step is equivalent to a 50% movement. So, there are only 4 values on this speed slider: 50, 100, 150, and 200. You can check how it works on HTML5 output by clicking here or pressing F5. To export it to eLearning outputs for viewers to interact with, in the Export tab, select HTML5, SCORM, or XAPI package as you wish. That's it! Controlling your video volume and speed with an interactive slider is easy like a piece of cake. Learn how to create a timeline slider or video editing tips here, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more helpful content. See you later!